Hey foodies, welcome to Cooking Shooking. How are you guys doing? I had already posted a homestyle mutter paneer recipe, which was my homestyle mutter paneer. Today I am going to show you how to make dhaba style mutter paneer, very easy and delicious, flavorful as well. Let's get cooking. Alright guys, before we begin the recipe, make sure to click the subscribe button below this video and ring the bell icon beside it so that you get notified as soon as I post a new video in the future. The first step in the recipe is to heat up a pan in high flame and add in about 4 tablespoons of oil. I know the quantity of oil is on the higher side, but as you are making it at home, you can reduce it down as you like it. Even 2 tablespoons should be fine. The halwa is that most dhabas add a lot of oil and vanaspati ghee, which is not good for health, but as I said, you can reduce it down if you want to. To the hot oil, I'm going to add in the sliced onions. I'm using 6 onions today. This is the onion based gravy, so we need to add a lot of onions and we're going to start stirring it around. Cooking the onions to a golden stage is a really important step in the recipe as it brings a sweet flavor to the sabzi. To accelerate that, we are going to add in salt, about 1 teaspoon of salt to the onions right now, and we are going to cook the onions until they start going golden. After about 5 minutes, you can notice how the onion has started to go golden. At this stage, I am going to add in about 1/2 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. If you don't eat ginger garlic, you can skip it as well. Now we have to get rid of the rawness from the ginger garlic paste. For that, we're going to just cook it for about 2 to 3 minutes. The onions are looking nice. Now I'm going to add in the chopped tomatoes to this. I'm using 2 tomatoes today. You can add in more if you want to, but remember, it is an onion gravy. We don't want to add a lot of tomatoes to this. The next step in the recipe is to cook the tomatoes really well for about 5 to 6 minutes minimum so that we can get rid of that raw tomato flavor. The tomatoes have turned completely mushy and that's what we are looking for. Now I'm going to just turn off the flame and as you can see, the onion tomato mixture has left a lot of oil which we added in the first. So what I'll do is just take the oil out and we're going to use this oil later in the recipe. Now we have to blend the onion tomato masala to a paste. For that, just let it cool down to room temperature. After that, you can add it to a blender jar with some water and blend it. Perfect, this is looking nice. Our paste is ready. Now let's make the sabzi. So I've cleaned the same pan and in the pan, I'm going to add in the oil that we saved from the onion tomato masala. Once the oil is hot and ready, I'm also going to add in a little bit of ghee, which is totally optional. I know the recipe is very fat heavy, but that's how it is generally. Once the ghee and oil is hot, I'm going to add in about 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, about 2 bay leaf which I have crushed. Now quickly add in the coriander powder and red chili powder. To prevent it from burning, you can also add in a little bit of water, but I'm going to directly add in the paste that we made. I'm just giving it a quick mix right now, but there is a lot of mixture left in the jar itself, which I'm going to get it out in a minute. Perfect, this is looking nice as you can see. Now we're going to cook it for about 3 to 4 minutes. To flavor the sabzi today, I am using some Kitchen King masala from a brand named Everest. You can also use some Maggi's Masala Magic, or if you want to skip both of these, you can also use some garam masala. The important step in the recipe is to cook this masala really well for about 4 to 5 minutes or until it starts leaving some oil from the sides. As you can see, the color has completely changed and this is looking very nice. It has left a lot of oil. You can also remove some oil if you want to at this stage, but it's totally fine for me. I'm going to add in some coriander leaves, a few leaves and a little bit of green chili as well. Here I have about 3 green chilies which I have slit, and about 3/4 cup of boiled peas. Now you have to mix this really well and cook the peas for about 2 to 3 minutes. You can also use frozen peas if you want to just blanch it once if you are using frozen peas. My mixture is looking good. Now I'm going to add in water to it, about 1/2 cup of water, and start mixing it around. You can add more water to get a thinner gravy if you want to, but now you can see the actual gravy, can't you? I'm going to add in about 300 grams of paneer to this after mixing it well. Our mutter paneer is almost ready and is looking absolutely fabulous. The only flavor that is not present in this mutter paneer right now is the flavor of charcoal that we get when it is cooked in a sigri in a dhaba. To get that flavor, I'm going to place a katori on top of this mutter paneer, turn off the flame and place in one live charcoal. Now I'm going to drop in a little bit of ghee on top of the charcoal and cover the matar paneer pan. Do not keep it for longer than 30 seconds, otherwise what will happen is the recipe will have a very strong charcoal flavor. After about 15 seconds, I'm going to open the pan and start mixing the matar paneer. The matar paneer is all ready to get served with some hot naan or roti. Doesn't this matar paneer look absolutely delicious? The flavor of that onion gravy that we made earlier and that little bit of charcoal that we added clearly shines, and this is a very nice dhaba style recipe. I hope every one of you try it with some tandoori rotis. It will be really delicious. I hope to see you in my next video. Thank you so much for watching this one. I usually upload new videos on Wednesdays and Saturdays. Thank you so much for watching this one. Bye. Take care. Happy cooking.